with the best movies to watch this season is the one, the only, Teri Hart. Movies and TV, so I'm very excited for this. You've got, you know, you've done the research, you've looked. What should we be watching? What's your first pick?
I have a really good mix of things to watch in the theaters and things to watch at home. The one I'm starting with, I know we're just getting through award season right now,
yeah,
but we already have a contender for next year's Oscars.
Oh my gosh.
Dune 2, baby. Dune 2.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
No, I know.
Tell us.
I can tell you're looking at me surprised because you're like, Teri Hart, I know you, and I know that, listen, the first one didn't light up my world.
Okay.
Film bros, don't come at me. It didn't. It didn't have enough feeling, you know?
Yeah.
I like movies that make me feel. This one got me in my feelings. Mm. There are so many storylines that pay off, and this cast is really the next generation of movie stars. When you see Timothée Chalamet and Zendaya on screen and their faces, it is just like, oh my goodness, those are movie stars. I saw, proper movie stars.
Okay.
I saw it in IMAX, and we love the fact that it was written and directed by Canadian. Didn't even live.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, incredible. Yeah.
So,
I will be looking out, and I am surprised.
It broke a bunch of box office records when it opened a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
It will be on everybody's lips for a while. You should probably watch the first one to see the second one. But the husband came with me. He didn't see the first. He could follow
along. And he was fine, right?
Fine.
Sometimes it's good, too, if the first one is like, then you see the second one, you're like, oh, my gosh, it's so much better. So that's kind of a good thing.
It's incredible filmmaking. Big, big, big Hollywood sci-fi filmmaking.
Okay. Yeah. The second one you've got on your list is a biography, right?
So I love a biopic that teaches me something and introduces me to somebody who I might not have known about, but really should know about, and that is Shirley.
Mm-hmm.
This is a biopic about Shirley Chisholm, who was the first black woman nominated to Congress, and then she ran for the 1972 Democratic presidential nomination.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a really interesting time in history because 1972 was the first year that the voting age in America went from 21 to 18.
Okay.
So it's a lot about the youth vote, and you're seeing here Regina King, who gives an this is exactly it. She disappears in this movie.
I'm like, who's playing Shirley?
Yeah, Regina King.
Wow.
And it is a jaw-droppingly amazing performance. Mm-hmm. One of those, like, she disappears into the role.
Like Malcolm X.
Yeah, totally. But also great performances by Lance Henriksen, R.I.P. to Lance Henriksen.
Mm-hmm.
He died last year, but he stars in this along with Terrence Howard, who are both part of her campaign group. This is on Netflix. Watch it. It's not only great, but it'll teach you some things that maybe you weren't aware of.
Yeah.
And the hardship she's endured, but it really focuses on the time and the place and the importance. Super worth watching, especially in an election year this year.
And that is history, the history that, you know, you might not be getting in schools. So it's nice to see these films that are catching us up, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
What do you got for us next?
Okay, so this movie, it is called 500 Days in the Wild.
Okay, she had to get, like, settled in. What's going on?
Okay, so we're going from big sci-fi to a biopic, and this is a documentary, 500 Days in the Wild. It's on Paramount Plus. It is about a Canadian, Diane Whelan, who set off from Newfoundland to Victoria.
Okay.
With no wheels. And by that, I mean the good old heel toe express. Do you know the saying heel toe express?
No, but I love it.
Yes, the heel toe express.
She walked.
Yeah. Okay. She walked. My parents used to tell me all the time,
hilarious.
You're taking the heel toe express.
My favorite mode of transportation.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
So she heel toe expresses it. From Newfoundland to Victoria, of course, there are lots of waterways in there, so she's kayaking and canoeing. She really did this to unplug, to stop the noise. She wanted to get quiet. And I don't know anybody who hasn't felt that. Her lessons that she learns along the way are incredible. The nuggets that she drops are like, woo, stop the presses. I need to be reminded of that. And one of the things, Trace, that was so heartening watching this is 100% of the people she came across in her travels were kind and lovely and helpful. And she talks about the fact that there is more niceness in the world mm-hmm. than shadow. Mm-hmm. And that really stuck with me.
Yeah.
It took her a lot longer than 500 days. I am not going to ruin it and tell you how long it took. But this is an amazing movie.
500 Days in the Wild. I'm shocked that I didn't know she was doing that. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm shocked about. And the other thing is, you and I have talked about this many times, the fact that I do believe people are essentially good.
I do
and
too.
Everything I'm seeing and watching is telling me otherwise. So it's really nice to be reminded of that, right?
Yeah.
Thank you for that. Okay, your next pick is a remake?
Yeah, this is a remake. If you were an 80s kid, if you know the 80s, Patrick
Swayze. I remember.
Yeah.
Patrick Swayze, yes.
He maybe made you sweat, maybe made you, you know, all the things.
The long hair and all.
Yeah, they've remade Dirty Dancing a bunch of times.
Yeah.
They are not remaking Ghost. Do not touch that movie.
Don't do it.
But they have remade Roadhouse.
Oh, okay.
This time with Jake Gyllenhaal. He plays a UFC fighter. He's always good with the action stuff.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd throw a little, you know, testosterone in my list.
Yeah, why not?
And Conor McGregor.
Someone's getting punched out.
If you like action, this is set in the world of bouncers and UFC, and so the action is going to be big and bold, and that's going to be on Prime Video.
Okay, very good. You can watch that one at home. Your next pick, romantic comedy, tell me more, because I don't see enough of those. Tell me, rom-com, God, what do you got?
Well, the Hallmark movie isn't just for Christmas anymore.
Good.
This is kind of like a St. Patrick's Day Boxing Day,
okay.
I guess is where we're at.
Okay.
And so we've got Lindsay Lohan in Irish Wish.
Okay.
Or it should probably be called Irish Be Careful What You Wish For.
Okay.
She plays a book editor who thinks she's in love with the author that she's working with.
Yeah.
He's marrying her best friend, which is complicated. And then she wishes, and her wish comes true, that she's going to marry Paul. Surprise, surprise. Paul might not be the right fit for her, the right lid for her pot.
Yeah.
And she discovers things about herself. This is a really, really easy-going, easy-breezy rom-com. You can watch it with the whole family.
Yep.
Sit down, Netflix it up, and you're good to go.
It's already happening. Eva and I are going to devour that, 100%.
And some popcorn. We've got some popcorn here. Take that popcorn home with you.
Your last one. Big
My
one.
My last one. Okay, so I'm mentioning this because I want to yell it from the rooftops.
Yeah.
If you haven't seen Bob Marley One Love, see Bob Marley One Love.
Where do we see it? Because I missed the screening.
Okay.
Valentine's Day it was out.
Yeah, yeah. So it opened about a month ago.
Yeah.
It will still be playing in some theaters.
Okay.
And
right.
then it's probably going to be on Paramount Plus.
Okay.
I loved this movie. Kingsley Benadire and Lashana Lynch playing Rita and Bob Marley. If the awards gods can remember them for next year, I would love it.
Yeah.
It focuses on a very specific time in Bob's life when he was making the seminal Exodus record and also when he was putting on a free concert in Jamaica that ended up threatening his life because of the political turmoil in Jamaica.
Yeah.
But I feel like the movie gives us enough of all aspects of his life so you walk away really understanding how important Bob Marley was, not just to Jamaica and the Jamaican diaspora around the world, but to culture, to an ideology that was filled with goodness. So Bob Marley, One Love, really, if you
Must
missed it,
see.
Catch up with it.
Teri Hart, thank you so much.